ductile breeder. So ductile is a characteristic which is good for structural element. Brittle is a characteristic opposite to ductile, which is more like a failure characteristic of glass. A failure characteristic of glass is brittle, okay? So that is not what we want in a structural element. So brittle and ductile. So let us go further into the detail. So we have given reinforced concrete. So these are reinforced concrete characteristic. Reinforced concrete, we know that the strain diagram looks like this. Last meeting, we provided this diagram and as a matter of caudal requirement, it was said that the compression side strain is 0.003. That is the concrete part strain. What about the rest of the parts? So the rest of the parts, there are only concrete and steel system. So the tension side is mostly by the use of steel. And because of that, this part doesn't participate anymore because it is already cracked from this point to that point. So the only participation is this one. So this one is actually what we call as the strain. And from that point, we know that that is a small c. From neutral axis to the extreme, compressive fiber, that is c. So it's easy to recall. See, just remember, extreme compression fiber. See, from extreme compression fiber to the centroid of the steel, that is D. So therefore, this is D minus C. Okay. And therefore, we can solve for this amount. Last meeting, we already talked about. So by ratio proportion, this is 0.003. Equal to what? Equal to this one, equal to this one. So D minus C over C. And therefore, simplify this one, multiply by that one. Right? So this is our formula for the description of. So last meeting, we already know this. But this is variable. Actually, this is the strain of the steel component. Variable because we do not yet decided what type of design mode we are going to use. Balance, under-reinforced, over-reinforced. So after the engineer decided to choose which one of the three, so we can say how much is this value. We can set the value of this, okay? Because if we set this as what? As the balance, so it means we can solve this value. So let us have an example later. Another thing, this design method will what? Create different influence on the reduction factor. The reduction factor is actually a diagram that shows the effect of different situations involving balance, tension control, compression control into the effect on reduction. The code states that the tension side could be as much as 0.005, no? Tension side is allowed to have as much as 0.005. Can stretch more than the concrete. Of course, steel can stretch. Elongation, steel can elongate more than concrete. Concrete cannot elongate. This is the elongation of concrete or compression of concrete. Compression On the other side is elongation. So elongation of steel could be more than 0.003, and the code set it is about 0.005 on the steel. So if that is the case, the code allows us to use the value 0.005. This is for our what? Strain. Reduction factor, strain. So if we have that strain for steel reinforcement, meaning our reinforcement is the first to experience yielding before the concrete experience cracking. So first yield, and therefore the whole structure is tension controlled, because the steel experience yielding first before the concrete cracks. Sir, the concrete already cracked from this point of view. We neglect that already because we already have this system. We already have the crack model. We are already on the third stage. So after the third stage, we are here already, and we are left with a small portion of concrete. We are left with the whole number of tension reinforcement. So that is the material that is now going to resist the load. And therefore, we don't want any amount of concrete to further crack. We already allowed cracking of concrete up to that point. Further cracking is not allowed. Further cracking will make this whole concrete reinforcement fall. So, ignore that. This crack is allowed. You see a real beam with cracks. That is okay. That is still allowed. However, those who are not civil engineers will not understand and will be what? Afraid to go inside the building. Think about what I'm saying is very specific. If the beam is like this, simple support or thick support, you should what? See the cracking here. The cracking here is different. This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about. The cracking here. Okay? So this crack is allowed. So after that, if you see the crack go farther up, you have already value of A there. Already have value of A. And you can estimate. As a civil engineer, you can estimate that. Still, I have 50 mm. If the 50 mm is gone and the cracking is decreasing the amount of A to, for example, 40 mm, then 25 mm, okay. That is the time that the whole thing will fail. Okay? Depending upon the what? The amount of dimension of the concrete structure, we can estimate the value of A. Right? That is what we mean by this one. No? We allow the steel component to be stretched, to be elongated 0.005, which is what? Greater than 0.003 at the top. Because doing that, what will happen? That is the time that we can visually see the beam to be like this. We can visually see, and that is what we meant by giving an alarm. That is an alarming situation. That is what we mean by the explanation a while ago that gives us an alarm. Alarm doesn't mean sound. this situation is already alarming, particularly if we also solve the maximum deflection, we already know the magnitude of this, how much is that. And that is a good signal for us to evacuate the floor, to evacuate the building. Okay? That is different when we are in the brittle zone. We cannot see anything. The structure is still horizontal and no deflection is visually observed. And yet, instantly, the beam will fail instantly without any warning. That is what we mean by without any warning. Just instantly fail, instantly fall. And that is more dangerous. That is why we always use tension control type of design. Tension control type of design meaning that is where we generate complication in such a way that the amount of steel is not so much. Just below the balance situation. Okay. Any question? So, if that is the case, for the beam, 0.005 experienced by the steel, it is what? Experience told them, meaning the committee on the code, that this is about 0.9. That is 0.9. That is 0.9. That is the amount of reduction factor to be used if the system is here, no? Meaning more than or equal to 0.005 or more than that amount is experienced by the steel. Okay.